Hey everybody, this is Jeff here with N Video Games for another episode of ActRaiser or ActRaiser, whichever you prefer, on the Super Nintendo. We left off with Bloodpool. We were working on that part of the game, and we're going to resume that here momentarily. So let's get started and check it out and see how things go. Move some stuff on my screen here. Bear with me a moment. There we go. Alright. Says, I just loaded up my save file. It says, welcome back, Sir Jeff. Did you get sufficient rest? Each new day, we must renew our effort to create a peaceful world for our people and their master. Here's Fillmore, which was we did in the last episode, and here's Bloodpool, which we I think we got some more to do there still. I think. Sir Jeff, I know it's unexpected, but our people in Bloodpool have something to tell you. My master, since you're in the last monster's lair, something very dreadful has occurred. A monster appeared from the old castle by the lake and demanded a sacrifice of us. We spent hours discussing this hideous demand, and sadly determined three people should be selected by drawing lots. Unfortunately, one of those to be sacrificed is my son, Teddy. My master, please go to the old castle and save our son and our land. So yeah, we left off with having to go to the castle here, which is right here. So we're going to be doing that here in a little bit. Waiting for the town under construction thing to go away. Wrong button. Let's see here. Any offerings we can take? Reet, that's it. Okay. Let's see what. Oh, no, no, no. Guess we go back to the Sky Palace. Select our magic. We're gonna use Stardust this time. So you decide to take magical Stardust. With this magic, countless shooting stars will rain down on your enemy. Sir Jeff, if we destroy the monsters in this area, people will no longer be scared of evil. Sir Jeff, are you ready? Yes, may luck be with you. Here's our mode 7 rotating into the castle. Here's a Bloodpool Act 2. Awesome music, of course. So we're basically on top of the castle now, I guess. On the outside of it. Now we're going inside. Some of these blue little imp-like guys walking around, some spikes on the ceiling. Elevator here. I don't remember if there's anything secret down here or not. Are we supposed to go up or down first? So there's rotating spikes down there at the bottom, you can see. If you go in there, you're gonna die. Got a source of magic there from the globe candle thing. Oh! Oh! Oh, crap. That ghost thing came out and knocked me backwards into the spikes and into the pit. Well, I got the source, so I can just go up now. Don't have to worry about going down. We got slimes on the walls here. Oh crap. Did not mean to do that. Oh. Specs on the top there too. Just one of those guys that knocked me back earlier. Skull-like things floating back and forth. Is I'll take two hits of the sword. I can kill them. Like so. Another section of the castle here. Whoever runs this castle didn't pay the power bill, I guess, because the lights keep going out. Landed right on an imp. Come on, light back up so I can see where I'm going, please. One of those gargoyle things. Another globe here with a full apple, restoring our health. Yeah, hurry up here, I'm at 70 seconds left. Another section of the castle, more slimes in the walls, and some stone platforms to jump through. Up and up, I guess. I think these drop right here, these stone platforms that are on these chains. There's spikes there in pits, as you can see. Yep, they're dropping as I jump on them. Another gargoyle statue. Another one down here. A couple of them, actually. Take three hits of the sword. I think. Yeah, three hits. And, little gargoyle skeleton thing there. Another source of magic. Some water here. Another skull enemy and another gargoyle skeleton. Shoots its arms out. Oh, kind of like a lightning beam thing here. We gotta time and jump through. Hate those gargoyle skeleton things, they're very annoying. Oh, we got a bit more time now. That's good. Another instance of waiting for platforms here. And the rotating spikes. More slimes on the wall. Go all the way down, but that's okay. Let's try and get over there to that candle orb thing on the left. That was what I was attempting to do. Though I did not do it very successfully, clearly. Right here, this is what I was referring to, which is a 1-up. Wait for my platform to come. There we go. And we can go in the door here to move on. Got a flying imp. Another gargoyle statue, another flying imp, another flying imp. Oh, I missed him. Come back here. These damn gargoyle statues, man, hit me every time. Keep thinking you can duck under their fireballs, I think you're supposed to jump instead. Another gargoyle skeleton. More platforming. Oh, these are the kinds that go into the wall there, as you can see. You come back out. So you have to time your jumps here. Gargoyle on the left there. Another candle globe thing. And an apple, I think. Oh, just fell. Gotta readjust myself for the timing here. Ah, there you go. Nice. Couple gargoyle skeletons. Our gargoyle statue. Didn't get hit by that time for once. Alright, here's the boss. This is wizard guy. Magic. There we go. Stardust magic jacks him up, as you can see. Well, I'll assume he hits him anyway. That was a waste. Didn't do anything that time. So he turns into this werewolf guy. I'm getting jacked up by him. Run! There we go. Killed him. Nice. Stardust makes that a lot easier because it does multiple hits. Bloodpool Act 2. Bloodpool Act 2 clear. 14,430 points. Word. People want to talk to me again. My master, we no longer have monsters here in Bloodpool. Thank you so much. My son, Teddy, has returned from the old castle carrying a precious scroll. We present the scroll to you as an offering. Please accept it. Thank you very much for taking care of us, my master. We can now look after ourselves. Please help make other lands as peaceful as Bloodpool. If you don't want to talk to me again. My master, it may sound strange to you, but please hear our plea. Our people have become bitter and selfish. We have so many quarrels and fights. I'm afraid that I worked them too hard in building our town and caused them too much stress. My master, have you anything that will calm the people? So, it's referring to these sword icons you see on the houses. We can't do anything with that yet. We have to go to another part of the game and come back here to solve that problem. The ActRaiser will do that in certain instances, where you have to come back to different areas you've already done before when you get stuff from from future areas. I think what we need is music, if I remember correctly, which we get from a different part of the game, as I mentioned. So we need to take our offering here, I think. Yeah, Source of Magic, that was what they were talking about. Go make sure we get the wheat here. I think we already got some, but we'll get some more just in case. Alright, so now we're ready to go on to the next area. We go back to move the Sky Palace here. Our next area is the desert area, Cassandora. I'm going to switch back to the magical fire, which allows us to throw fireballs to the right and left, according to the game. We're going to save it here, which is the little feather icon there on next to the controller. And yes, we do want to continue. Alright, so we're going to do Cassandora Act 1 now. Which is in this kind of Stonehenge-looking circular rock formation. Alright, here we are, Cassandora, the desert area. Clearly, since you see there's sand everywhere. One of those blue imps, and a cactus there with spikes on it. Probably would hurt us if we jump on it. And there's like a dinosaur skeleton thing there as well. Maybe it's a dragon, I don't know. Something like that. So this is moving sand here, you'll fall down. And there was that enemy down there, the plant thing, which will hurt you. One of the spikes, a fire ball thing in the sky that we can kill with our sword, apparently. Oh, there, I jumped into the cactus there a couple times inadvertently. And again. Not very good at jumping over those cacti, apparently. Now here's a different one that you get to go up the hill and it's moving you back down. There's one of those plant things. Avoid those. Easier to do that than try to fight them. Another blue imp here. Ah, he threw a green thing at me. Fire thing here. More imps. Oh, I'm playing around a cacti. Cactus, rather. Thank goodness there's an apple there for us. It's getting jacked up. Turn around, face the correct direction, please. Another fireball guy up here. Green cactus balls, I guess those are supposed to be. I don't know what they are. You're pissing me off, come on here. Yeah, that's right, you better run away. Hit by a spear there. I don't think there's anything down there, but there might be. I don't know. I'm just gonna go in the door. I think it was just a pit. So you gotta jump across these pillars here. And hopefully avoid the enemies. Bee-like enemies here. These little cave-type things. for them to go back in so you don't get hit. And knocked into a pit, which would be bad, of course. Our globe here, which is a source of magic that we just got there. That's nice. So when you're falling, you can kind of control your descent a little bit with the control pad. So that's something that's nice to keep in mind. Just gotta go back in. There we go. Maybe this one will go back in as well. And then we'll jump across. Got hit by that one, inadvertently. Anything down here? No, just enemies. Just enemies. Jump back up here. Can't make that. Alright, we'll go back across then and do it that way. There's something up there. It's a candle glue thing. Oh, crap. Oh, no! He knocked me off and I didn't make it up there in time. Damn it. I'm about to die. One more hit and I'm dead. I'll get an apple or something. Ah, there's one. That was luck. So here's the boss. This kind of Sarlacc looking thing, I guess, for lack of a better description. Like a, I don't know, sand monster. Type of thing. Fireballs work pretty good against this guy. Multiple hits and all that. Hard to jump over those things. So the sand keeps pushing back down towards them, as you can see. Oh. Oh my god, that was so close! Oh my goodness, I had one hit left on me, and he had two hits left on him. If I got hit one time, I would have been dead. Yeah, it was really close. I need 100 points that time. Alright, so we're back to the Cassandora here, for the simulation portion of Cassandora. The part one of the simulation portion, I should say. There's our people going into the temple. Sir Jeff, Cassandora may become a land where people can live in peace. Alright, my master, let us work towards peace. And they want to talk to us right away, of course. My master, this is Cassandora, a desert town. Please send rain to wash away the sand so we may cultivate the fields. I guess they don't like their desert. So as the guy there mentioned, you have to use rain to get all the sand to go away. Trying to take out some of these enemies here. Rain, of course, is one of your miracles you can use. And there it goes, it melts away the sand. Like so. Requires 20 SP to use rain. Be nice if I had to select it once and then hit a different button to use it again, but so I reveal the layer of the bats there, so I can get the people to go seal that now. And I need to go find the layers of these red dragons and get those sealed up as well. I think one of them's right here. Oh, ran right to the bat. Red devils, I think they call them. I mean, people want to talk to us again. My master, some of our people ventured into the vast desert and lost our way. Please lead us to them. Melt away the sand with the rain. Appears someone has found something in the monster's lair. My master, we have found a strange bow and some arrows. We present this to you as an offering. Please accept it. I shall, because that helps me kill the red devils. This appears to be an angel's arrow. This is all we have for this year. Thank you for accepting our humble offering, my master. Power of the angel's arrow seems to have increased. Bam! One shot the red devils. That's a lot to see. Alright, gotta melt some more sand here. Or wash away, I guess, technically. This reminds me of, what was it, Skyward Sword? That had told you the type of item you had each time you got one. Or you have to read the text every time. Kind of annoying. You've got 57 of these here. You probably want to know about it again. Whoops, I just used rain on the wrong thing. Since said Sir Jeff, unfortunately nothing really happened. That's what happens if you accidentally use it on the wrong square like I just did there. So I was too busy talking and hitting the button repeatedly to scroll the text. There we go, now we can build a path to the person there. It's was lost in the desert, and they'll go rescue him. There's blue dragon up there too. So the fields will dry out in this in Cassandora, like so. We have to use rain to revitalize them. It says if you send rain, the crops will grow, and any dried up fields will be nurtured back to full productivity. That's the other thing you can use rain for. Like so. Hit him. Dang it. The blue dragon just nuked one of my houses. Jerk. Oh, the red dragons will. The red devils will drop your fields too. That's what happens. Okay. We leveled up. Level 7, hit points for 14. Level increase again when we get 1500 people. Use rain again here. We have 140 SP now total. Gotta revitalize the field. Basically, what you want to do in Cassandora is get rid of all the sand by using rain on every sand square there is. Obviously, you should go in directions to seal the monster's lairs off first, ideally. In terms of what sand you wash away first. Aw, Andrew's powers no more. People won't talk to me again. My master, thank you for leading us to them. Sadly, life had already left the missing man when we arrived. We plan to bury him near the shrine. The missing man was found holding a strange scroll in his hand. My master, we present this to you as an offering. People won't talk to me again. My master, Cassandora is the birthplace to the marvelous art form music. I compose this music for the man who lost his life in the desert. Music has mysterious powers. By listening, people can calm their hearts and soothe their pains. My master, we present you with the music as this year's offering. So that was the music I was referring to before for Bloodpool. So we need to get that from them and take it back to Bloodpool. It's called Harmonious Music. And the other thing that the scroll they were talking about, of course, is the source of magic. So I gotta wash away some more sand here. Music is pretty nice. In all honesty. In the rain right there. Don't drop the field. Go away, red devils. Alright. Go seal these layers here. There was a blue dragon's lair. Stand still. They found something in the blue dragon lair. Found a strange statue, which is a bomb, which destroys flying monsters. Like so. Bam! Alright, go down here until the Red Devil's lair. One of them, anyway. We got another one we gotta seal still. Up north. That's one right here. Gotta wash away some sand before we can get over there, though. Still in the lair in the south there. So that one's taken care of. Civilization level Castanora seems to have improved. Now we can sell the northern one. You can push them off the map sometime too, like that. Just deal with these red devils in the north here. If you hit them far enough back, because the arrows will do knockback damage to them. Which is kind of nice. Beneficial, so you don't have to kill them all the way. Let's knock them off the map. Alright, that one's sealed. Civilization has improved. So we can get rid of all the monster layers. Let's wash away the rest of the sand. A tremendous rain fell in the northern desert, revealing a pyramid. We sense an evil presence exuding from it. We will be investigating the matter. We will let you know what our investigation uncovers. That's the pyramid there up north. That pyramid has been enticing us. Those who went to investigate the pyramid have not returned. When we sealed the fire monster's lair, the pyramid revealed its true purpose. The pyramid is the main monster's lair. Oh, master, please come down and seal this evil pyramid. So that's going to be Act 2 for Castanora. We have to go into the pyramid. We're gonna finish washing away the sand here before we do that, though. I think there's something up there at the eagle drawing thing in the top left, right up here. You can get something from that, too. I'm gonna send the people up there, if I remember correctly. I guess the music isn't that great, because the people are sad we want the music playing. That was supposed to solve all our problems. Guess not. Pyramid overrides some overrides music, I guess. Don't have enough SP, can't use it. However, we need 20 SP to create a rain cloud, it says. Is that a way for my SP to recover? Which I think it slowly regenerates over time, but when your people come out of the shrine, they'll give you some back too. To recover here. And six more. Here's a dog. Hey dog, what's up? Here, now we got enough to use rain again. Plant those fields, oh yeah. Alright. Yeah, we know how rain works. Yeah, let's see, three more squares we gotta wash away. Need more SP again. So remember that they talked about using wheat to help out other towns? Watch this. Not that one. Can't you tell what the man was feeling when he wrote this music? However, my master music is the one calming influence in people's lives. This item should be given to the people when they are discouraged. I didn't mean to use that one. So this is what I was talking about. Use the wheat. Watch. Magic! It gets replanted as a wheat field instead of a cornfield. Wheat is better in terms of providing more food for your people, thus higher population capabilities. But you can only use it one wheat per field, so it's not one for the whole town, I don't think, if I remember correctly. So you have to use a separate wheat on each one, which is kind of annoying. Alright, don't have enough SP yet. My bad. I was going to use another rain cloud, but didn't have enough yet. Now we do. Once the tenor under construction message goes away, since we can't trigger the menu while that's active. But now all future fields they plant will be wheat, as you can see with this one right here that I'm standing next to. We leveled up. Level 8 we have now achieved, and we have 15 hit points. And we'll get another level when we get 1,700 people. And of course, it's referring to your total population for all your towns, not just the current one you're working on, which is the second number on the top right of the screen. And leveling, of course, refills our SP meter. So we'll be able to use rain here on all three of these, or all two of these last scores, I should say. One more to wash away. Whenever it lets me. There we go. Alright, there we go. No more sand. I'm gonna go up here to the eagle inscription. Before I go into the pyramid. Like I said, I think there might be something up there. Can't remember. But I think there might be. Yeah, build up in that direction to get trigger the people to go over there. dogs is gonna get in the way, I guess. Walking back and forth, people are gonna be building. And it disappeared, the dog did. There he is, the dog's back again. What up, dog? So I can't go up any further up this way because there's this mountain in the way, obviously. But maybe the people will give me a message about finding something over there. I think there is something there, but like I said, I'm not 100% certain on that. Don't remember. It's been a while since I've played all the way through this game. I'm just waiting to see if they trigger anything with that eagle design up there before I'm going to do the pyramid. We got another level. Level 9, hit points are 16. Then another level again when we get 1900 total people. Do a little bit more time here and see if it triggers anything. If not, I'm going to go ahead and go in the pyramid. Maybe something you have to do after the pyramid, I can't remember. Alright, I guess it's not going to do anything, so we'll go ahead and go back to the pyramid now. Don't know which magic I need for this one, so let's keep the one we have. Go ahead and save it though, just in case. This is the same thing as usual, basically. Now we're gonna go into the pyramid. Get our Egyptian action on. Cassandra Act 2, Pyramid Interior. There's those snakes running around on the ground there. Got a pharaoh mask on the wall that shoots arrows. Mummy. A couple of them. Okay, make that four of them. Oh, we can't hit that. Got a guy with a sword here. An eagle man or something, I guess. Covered in. Next area. More pharaoh masks and then a fire blue fireball running around. Oops. And these inclines here will make you fall, as you can see. I guess they are supposed to have sand running on them or something kind of like in Sonic the Hedgehog. It's a scorpion type of thing, and another fireball, some scarabs on the wall, spikes. I think these are platforms, yeah. It's a moving platform on the wall there. Blue thing, which is a source of magic inside. Another elevator. A lift, whatever you want to call it. Another moving platform. Series of them. Got a one-up up there in the upper orb. Almost fell. Wasn't bad. Alright, there you go. That was close too. There's nothing down here. Nope. Me dying, that's what's down there. That was pretty dumb of me. My source of magic again. Back up on to the left. Some Anubis statues in the background. Obelisks. Very Egyptian here. Oh, that was close. Oh, lucky there. That was pretty close too. I'm trying to go back up to get that one up again is what I'm trying to do, in case you were wondering. I had the timing of the platforms correct though, to be able to do so. There we go, I'm on one up. Oh, landed on the spike, that was not good. Kill the scorpion and the fireball. Some pharaoh statues in the background. On my left here. Another scorpion, which I jumped into inadvertently. There's another candle globe thing up here. So full apple and fully restore health. Awesome. Good times, good times. Going up. Couple of scorpions, another fireball. You gonna come back out or you just gonna stay in the door? I get hit by one on the door, that makes sense. It's the eagle man again. You see all these little ball things that explode. There's things in the ceiling. More snake platforms and pharaoh masks on the wall with the arrows that I'm getting hit by constantly. Alright. Several snakes on the ground here. Take care of all of them. Mummy. More spikes. Oops. I was gonna jump across, but then I changed my mind when I saw the mummy and I couldn't make it back in time. So I was already mid-jump. Oh. Speaking of jumps, I almost went right into the spikes. So I gotta keep going left here so I don't fall in and wait for the lift to come back down. And I screwed that one up, clearly. Those are instant death spikes if you touch those. As you saw. What you're supposed to do is jump on the lift, obviously. I forgot you can kill the arrows. With your sword. Alright, let's try this again without landing on the spikes this time. That would be nice. This is the part I was referring to. Like the lift. It goes all the way down, so you have to time it correctly. You have to wait till it's on the upswing, like so. Don't you knock me back down in there now. That was close. Here's an apple. Yep. Another eagle man, he shoots beams with his sword. And jumps too. stronger version, obviously. Got hit several times, unfortunately. I think this is the boss. Yep. It's a Sphinx thing. Which I just got hit by. 4 things on the wall that will shoot at you. Pharaoh masks. Got hit by that one. Getting jacked up here. There we go. I killed him. Not too difficult. Fire makes it easier. Stardust will probably work fine for that too. Either one. Use fire wings on the ground or Stardust wings in there. 17,160 points. People want to talk to me again. Thank you, my master, for sowing the evil pyramid. The man who was lost and died in the desert was probably enticed by the pyramid's magic power. Thank you so much for taking care of us. We can now look after ourselves. Please help other lands become as peaceful as Cassandora. You want to talk to me again? Too many of our people are dying of the plague, my master. I'll try to say that part. It is terrible to see so many suffer, wither, and die. Please give us some herbs. Please save us some suffering and bring peace to our lives. So the herbs, that's something else I have to get from another area and come back here. You see, that's a recurring trend in the game. And there's the people crawling on the ground that you see. That's the people that have the plague that I mentioned. So we have to come back here. We can't do anything with that yet. But we can go back to Bloodpool and use music. Which will solve the quarrels here of the people. See, the sword icons are gone. Bloodpool, we just have to finish building up. Well, I guess technically we don't have to, but if you want to maximize your levels and your population, you can keep building it up. And people want to talk to me. My master, Bloodpool has extended its borders to the far reaches of the ocean, but the man's invention of a device known as a compass, our navigational ability has improved tremendously. We present this compass to you as an offer, and please accept it. My master, that is called a compass. This great invention will always tell you the direction of your travels. This also enables people to navigate the open seas for fishing. Fishing though. That's weird. Maybe they met out here? Oh yeah, there it is. They were fishing out there on the open sea. Alright, so we gotta move on past Cassandora now. Because they have the plague and we need the herb to cure them. We go to Marana. Island area there, or Atos, or Northwall. Those are our options. See, it moves pretty slowly. I think Atos, however you say that, is the next area to go to. There's a volcano, which you see there at the opening. Alright. Save it again. I don't know what magic we need here, so we're just gonna stick with the fireball. Fight. It's got another Stonehenge looking circle formation here. Apparently it's pretty common in the world of ActRaiser. So this is kind of like a mountain area, as you can see. A bamboo forest and some bamboo spikes that fall down. More of these guys throwing stones at me that we saw earlier in the game. Got hit by the spikes. Almost got hit by them again. Thought you could jump on top of them, but I guess not. These winged chariot platform things. These are pretty annoying. So you have to ride on them and not get hit by the enemies, because you will fall in the pit if you do. That was luck on my part. That's not good. That was what I was referring to. More or less. I fall in the lava. Go down so I can go down. Alright, let's try this again. Basically, try to avoid getting hit as much as possible, but sometimes it's unavoidable. Alright, here we go. Finally made it to the end. Boulder throwing hand thing. And a gem there for 500 points. Where's the boulder hand? There it is. And there, a guy throwing rocks. Rocks everywhere. I guess you could say this level really rocks. Oh, that was terrible. And it kind of doesn't. It kind of sucks, actually. It's a little bit on the difficult side. Some of the platform aspects, anyway. More volcano stuff. Guess we're going here. Another winged thing shooting tornadoes at me. I could probably use an apple right about now. Anybody get some apples? Apple, please. And there's the boss, I think. Maybe not. Well, that was a destroy all enemies thing. Got the orb. Here's another orb. There we go, there's an apple. Finally. Oh man, I almost fell in the pit. That would've been bad. Ah. Nice, I can shoot sword beams now. Check that out. From that orb I got. Here's the boss. Stardust would have been better at this, for this boss. Clearly. I missed them all four times I used magic, I missed them. Good job. Good job, Jeff. So as long as you get that sword upgrade, you can just stand in one place and just fire at him. If you have full health, and you'll outlast him because your sword does more damage than he does. So Atos, Act 1, clear. Atos, however you say that. 13,020 points. Of course, they want to talk to me right away, like they always do. Oh, my master, this great plateau, Atos, has laid uncultivated for many years. Please use the mighty power of lightning to destroy these rocks so we can begin to build and cultivate the land. So, this one, instead of using rain, we have to use lightning to get rid of all the rocks. Bam! You can zap the enemies with lightning too, as I mentioned in the previous episode, which is nice. Bam! Sucker. Sail the layer of the blue dragon over to the left there. We got enough of a path to do so. We got these skull enemies now too. These things are a real pain in the ass. They're even worse than the blue dragons. They take a ton of hits. So this time they don't build farms, they build these little ranches. You gotta seal the skull there too. So lightning doesn't even kill the skulls, it just sits there and looks at you like you're an idiot. I'm gonna change direction here and do the skull one first. So those are more difficult to kill than the blue dragons are. There we go, got rid of that one. Found something in the lair, of course. Found a strange statue, which is a bomb. You wanna talk to me? Oh, my master, my husband suffered serious injuries while sealing the monster's lair, so I alone must continue the building of Atos for a while. Get rid of that blue dragon. Another blue dragon lair up here, we gotta use lightning to clear the trees as well. Oh, my master, one of our people went to seal the monster's lair, even though he was also seriously injured. After sealing the monster's lair, he was fatally injured. He is now standing before the shrine with his last ounce of strength. His last request is to pass away while being covered by my master's tears. Please grant his request. Send the rain. There he is, next to the shrine. So you gotta make it rain on top of the shrine where he's standing. Is happy. Happy to get rained on, I guess. That his face will shower with his master's tears was peace enough. Oh, master, thank you for showing compassion on him in his great hour of need. Don't be burning my houses down. Fool. Another one up here too. Well, two of them left, we have seal. Come on, let me change the build pathway, please. My master, this year our ranch has some horses.
Okay, that's nice.
Thanks for stopping me to tell me that.
Ah, he flew right into the lightning. What an idiot. I think he's zapped on all my houses, I heard it. Yep. This other one over here. What a jerk. Goes again, zapping all of them. Level up. Now level 10. 17 hit points. And they're level what? 2200 people. My horse is hanging out outside there. I guess. Where are you going, fool? I'll zap you. No, don't be zapping my houses. I'm trying to zap you. Stop dodging my arrows. Jerk. Alright. I'm gonna seal this one and then we're gonna call it because it's been an hour, and I need to get ready for the stuff I gotta do this evening. I zapped another one of my houses because he's a jerk. But like I said before, the people rebuild on the burned out houses, if you tell them to. You wanna talk to me again? My master, the wind is gone, and without it, our windmills won't work. Would you cause the wind to blow, please? Stand still. Gosh. Found something in the monster's lair. My master, we found a strange bow and some arrows. It's the angel arrow power-up thing. Wind is another miracle you can use. Our powerful wind will blow away all flying creatures. That's something else you can use to get rid of the flying creatures, and it makes the windmills go again, as you saw there. Alright. So I'm gonna have to call the stream here. I got plans this evening I gotta get ready for. But thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching. You can hit the follow button here on Twitch to follow along with our streams. We stream on Sundays, Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. 8 p.m. Eastern is our normal time. We're gonna be resuming our normal time of streaming on Tuesday. And Tuesday coming up will be, let's see, that will be GoldenEye on the N64 will be our next stream on Tuesday. And you can follow along with us on YouTube as well. We have video series there. We do on Mondays, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. We have a new video each day except for Sundays. That's our only off day, except for streaming, of course. But yeah, you can subscribe on there to follow along with that. And then you can check us out at nvideogames.com for Nintendo news, screenshots, trailers, and lots more good stuff. You can follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/nvideogaming or on Twitter at twitter.com/nvideogames. So thanks for watching and game on.